So tomorrow when you're running, you know it's gonna hurt, but you also know the race could be decided by one place,
Ooh.
One point. And so when you're sitting there saying it hurts too bad, I guarantee you, when the race is over, the hurt will go away if you gave your best.
There's a moment if your bones win, when the fire takes over. Blood is running, heart is pumping, as the battle gets closer. They can say what they want now.
What I love about cross country is just how different it is. Cross country is pretty rough. The terrain, the footing, everything is a little bit different on a cross country course. It's that kind of challenge that I like. There are no timeouts, there's no defense, can't sub. We line up guys, the gun goes off, and it's really up to the athletes to do their very best.
Your arms, set, go!
Cross country is, in essence, a very simple sport. You know, you just run a distance. But people don't realize how much of a mental challenge it is, and that's the aspect of the sport I really enjoy.
Distance running is painful, and it takes a lot of effort, and it takes a lot of dedication, and again, irrespective of what your talent level is, you have to put in that work. Everybody's got the exact same goal, to be the very best runner that they can be. That comes out in cross country, and that's not the case, I think, in other sports.
But these are people that wanted to keep on going. That's, I think, character. That defines what this team is really all about. So those of you that did 18 and were pushing yourselves, fantastic. That was awesome.
Good job.
Okay, Carmel rules on three. One, two, three. Carmel rules!
Surrounded by a team and having everyone work together and motivate each other, because I think that's most important. Instead of being out there by yourself, that's what I love about it, and I love having that second family.
I saw great support for each other. I saw people cheering. I saw people helping each other, being enthusiastic to one another. That's a team, man. It's a visual council round plus that. Yeah.
This particular team really did come together. I think that there was a unity that existed on the team, a camaraderie that existed that maybe hadn't been there a few years ago, that definitely has been building and definitely, I think, really came together where people generally liked hanging out with one another.
But everyone seemed to be really sort of engaged and supportive, and it was definitely a little more cohesive than it seems like it has been in the past.
The social aspect and the team spirit was very much alive and strong.
Happy birthday, dear Mason. Happy birthday to you.
One of the peaks of the season was definitely during the fall break. The varsity team, both girls and boys, went up to Shasta for high altitude running. The team really bonded well together, and you know, during dinners we just all have fun. It was rambunctious. And everybody was laughing.
From practices where we were running exhausting mile repeats, I hear the droning voice of Coach Clifford, "Come on, keep on going, you're at the half mile mark, keep on going. Just make the second half faster than the first." And I let those words settle in, and each time I would come out faster and faster.
We had high goals for this season. We really wanted to accomplish some big things. But we wanted to win league. And we thought we had a real shot at doing things, but we came up short in those. There was a level of disappointment.
After my disaster of a PG race, I ran probably my worst race there and nearly fell to dehydration afterwards.
girls were second and not too far off PG, but we didn't get it done. And I know that there was a level of disappointment on the girls' side. On the guys' side, I think we thought we could have beaten King City pretty comfortably. Greenfield might have been a little bit of a stretch for us, but we came up short on those.
Something about the course, something about just the day. I didn't run my best, and so it was kind of bittersweet.
It's tempting to sell yourself short a little bit, not to set really high goals for fear of coming up short. That wasn't a good feeling. But truly the joy and the enthusiasm and euphoria of accomplishing it, those goals when you do reach them is going to be spectacular.
Let's go, Miles! Let's go! Yes! Woo!
Today was a challenging workout. Absolutely it was. Use what you learned today in the meet on Thursday.
My favorite thing is running intervals on the track and being able to break times. Nobody looks forward to running on the track. Nobody looks forward to running their heart out. But somewhere during the second half of the year, I realized I was kind of on my way out and that this was the senior year that I would like to think about.
We are very, very close, up and down the line, every single place. I don't care if you're the number one or the dead last on our team, every single place matters, right? It does.
And so it totally changed my perspective, and I was happy to do hard workouts. I wanted to do more of them.
They were motivating, like, oh, come on, you got this, keep going. And that's what really helped me keep going, because I could have easily given up.
Three full months you guys have been running. You've been running and building up for this one race. I know it sounds like a lot, but in fact, that's the reality. That's what MTEL Championship is. There's a lot of people that put a lot of time into this, and I want you guys to think about that. Why were you doing it? Why have we worked so hard? Because you guys want to win.
A lot of it's in your head, you guys. So, you know, the attitude you bring tomorrow is gonna make a huge difference.
Yep.
Back mile, you push it, Michelle, let's go!
It's like, I love them.
And bang.
Some of my highlights was definitely coming back at MTALs and placing in the top 10. That was really big for me because I got my personal best for a 3 mile, and I was also able to shave off a few seconds from my average mile.
Hey, yo, buddy. Let's go.
Let's go, Connor.
The MTEL was awesome. Got second place. Only 10 seconds behind the guy who won CCS the year before and a couple years before that.
Beating my personal best by 2 seconds on MTALs was just huge.
It was my last race as a cross-country runner, and I went out, ran my race, and I was happy, thoroughly happy.
Everybody doing CCS, just the team seemed a lot more together, and we all seemed to have one mindset, and everybody had PRs during that race, and you know, everybody was just in such a good mood and good spirits, and I think we had a lot of fun.
Getting to come home on that bus feeling like we had a victory, it was a team victory. Being able to support each other, being able to have that care for everyone, being the best that they could.
I'm really proud of absolutely everybody. There wasn't a single effort out there that was not just top notch. That was a great, great performance today. My hat's off, right? It is now. My hat's off to you guys. That was an awesome, seriously, an awesome job.
This program's been going on for, you know, 4 years now, and it's really starting to get somewhere, I think. A lot of young kids joining, and our older leadership is just getting better and better.
Yeah, and I'd like to say thank you to Coach Cease, Coach Montgomery, Coach Lino, Coach Price.
Obviously, thank you to Coach Clifford for spending enormous amounts of time with us and making it all possible.
They're always motivating and always pushing us to do our best, because I don't think we could have been the team we were this year without any of them.
Thank you, coaches. You know, I can't thank you enough. It's my senior year, and I wish I had more.
Let's have that football team here's back to Carmel. Please him out. Carmel on 3. 1, 2, 3.
Carmel!
Yay!
It's how I'm feeling inside that's annoying my vibe.